Hello, everybody. Lighten the candles and lighten the incense for tonight's talk. Because I have been feeling very magical today. Okay. So on tonight's episode of Trauma and Tarot and Talk, I do want to pull the cards for Trauma and Tarot, but I also, let me get this shared. So also I want to take the opportunity to, talk a little bit about magic. Hello there. Thank you for joining. So, in tonight's episode, I want to talk about some magic and some... I will pull the cards for Trauma and Tarot as well. We've got the music going here, and everything's flowing really good. I do have the cauldron, so if you want a reading, comment your birthdate, and I will pull from the cauldron, and we will see what type of divination you get, and I will pull it from the shelf. So anyway, what I wanted to talk about was magic. But I'm waiting on some more people to come in here. Hello, darling. 41691. All right, let's go straight into it. And for you, I pulled the Tarot Illuminati deck. So let's go grab it. Oh. I have about 21 different types of divination. So if you're just joining me, that's what this is. If you've never seen any of my stuff before, that's what it is. I have different types of divination, cards, oracle, pendulum, witches' runes, tarot dice, all those kind of things, just to get an answer. Some of the oracles speak certain ways, so then you get those types of reading as well. But for the tarot Illuminati, you might get more from the pictures. Oh, the Ten of Wands. So you've been having... I know, it's like an addiction, isn't it? Like, once you get a couple types, you're just like, soul, just give me them all! Okay, so first card is the Ten of Wands. So you're overburdening yourself with what's going on in your life right now. You're struggling, you know what you want, you have your goals, this is the Princess of Wands. You know what you want, but you're just having a hard time getting it. The thing is the Hanged Man, so what this is telling me is that maybe you should take a step back and reevaluate the situation. There are other avenues to get to the end game of where you are at or where you want to be. So follow through with that and you will come out of it well. I bet you. Let's see the last card. Five of Wands. Boy, all these wands. Okay, so I feel like the inner conflict will be over. I do feel like an ending. Yep. The Four of Swords is the ending of something, so here we go. I hope that resonates with you, darling. So I have an announcement. I am now a keen psychic, so I'm so excited. I started just a couple days ago. Actually, yesterday I started... really getting into it. I had my training over the weekend, and so far everything's going good. So, if I'm good enough for, you know, these online companies, give me a chance. I'm giving readings for free. Give me a chance and book with me. Anyway, I'm running a special right now, and there's only 2 days left to get in on that. So if you book a reading, if you're local, so if you're in Central West Virginia or North Central West Virginia, because I'm in Clarksburg, the cat. When the cat wants attention, you have to get it. Anyway, if you book a reading with me, or Reiki with me, or even Power Forms, you get an access bar session for free. What those are is the points on your head. I just lightly touch them, do my energy work, and you feel amazing afterwards. It's kind of like decluttering the mind. So it really makes you feel good. I mean, you do feel a little lightheaded whenever you first get up, but it's like an overall calming energy shift. But you get that for free right now, but you have to book up until the end of September. The thing about that is you can book anytime. So if you want a couple's time to come and get readings, or if you and your best friend want to come and get readings, and I can do the bars at the same time, as long as you book it before the 31st, I will still honor that. It doesn't matter if you book it for next week, if you book it for 6 months from now, my calendar is open. So book it, and Valentine's Day, Christmas, be thankful for somebody, and book an appointment with me. Anyway, that's my plug. That's what's going on right now. I'm really excited about. All right, Barbara. Madeline, thank you, honey, for the follow. Okay, so healing cards for Barbara. Now, these are the cards that I use for my blog every week. I pick a different card, and then I write about it. And this week, I'm going to tell you it's about saying what you mean and speaking your truth. So, I'm not going to show you that card unless it gets drawn for you. Okay. You know, whenever I first started doing cards and stuff, my music in the background was instrumental and binaural beats and things like that. And it shifted to the music that I really get into and that really relaxes me and gives me a certain vibe. And this is the type of music. So this is my YouTube playlist that's playing in the background. All right, Barbara. I got you, darling. So, temptation. Sexual arts. And entrapment. So, by these cards, it automatically assume that there is a situation where you feel that you are not being able to be yourself, that you are stuck in a rut, you're maybe even being kind of held hostage, so to speak, by sex. It's sex being used as a weapon, and you know, that's kind of almost what the vibe that it feels like. You should never compromise yourself. You should never feel that you have to be stuck in a situation like that. So I really hope that is not the case for you, but that is what popped out to me. Okay. Anybody else in here want to say hello? If not, I will go right into talking about magic and how it's done, and I'm going to tell you what I did. And I'm not complaining about it. This is just how things can go wrong. Okay, so on Llamas, we had a gathering, and we made, it was a big, bright idea to make prosperity spell jars. This is great, except the stuff that I put in mine, apparently I wasn't specific enough. So it's almost like, okay, well, I know what to, you know, it needs to be fixed. Because while I asked for prosperity, it came out more of abundance. So we're getting an abundance of things, and our lives are improving. Financially, it's not. And we all want that financial, you know, shift up, right? So probably, okay, so not August 1st is Llamas. We had it before then. But it's the first harvest, so it was about reaping what you've sown and then, you know, getting your due. That's what this was for. Not specifying. Now I have to open it up. And I've decided that I'm going to take it all out and pour it in a bowl. Get a piece of paper and write out my intention. Burn it over top of it. Let the ashes get down into this. Mix it all up and then reseal it. Sealed it with gold glitter. And put it in the form of a star and glittered around it, you know, to seal it off. But there's nothing wrong with opening up the spell jar. You know, if it's still working and the power is still there, then you can certainly reset it. It was a couple weeks ago that I actually made a TikTok about this. And I was like, well, it doesn't seem to be working, but let's give it a couple turns. You know, three turns for the next 3 days. So that's what I did. And holy crap. Things are flowing in, and which, yeah, like my birthday. My birthday came, I was not expecting anything, and I was blessed this year. I feel like I was blessed. That's setting your intentions and things coming forth to you. Okay, so, also, now it didn't backfire, so it's not bad magic. It's not that anything bad was done. It's just that it needs to be specified more. You can take a bay leaf. I can take a bay leaf and write on it and then burn it and let the ashes go in there just as good as I can take a piece of paper or a piece of parchment and write on there and add to it as well. I'm not going to tell you all the things that are in here, but there is a piece of quartz, there is a piece of citrine, there is a piece of aventurine in here, along with various herbs. Okay? So, that being said, today, this morning, actually, there was a storm that rolled through, and the thunder clap from that was, I felt like Thor descended and said, you, now you have work to do. So I was like, oh, okay. Like, I was tingling all over my body, cold chills. I really felt the energy from it. And so I went out and I did a little video because the sun was out here and the thunder was over here, and it was nice. But anyway, it's on my TikTok. You can follow me on TikTok at Lady Gwen Healing, there on TikTok. So anyway, what I did was I collected some of the rainwater. And I got it in this little bottle right here. And I do have more, but this is all that I'm going to need to cast my next spell. And it is so cold. Oh my gosh. It is still so cold. So it is so energized. And it's just unreal. Like, that's for a very special spell. So I'm really excited to do that. Matt, I'm going through, and I have been going through a lot of changes, and like on my website, my blogs, my vlogs, everything I talk about is trauma situations and working through them. And while my life isn't fully traumatic, it is awareness of what other people go through. And that's why I pulled the cards for trauma and tarot. So what I'm feeling with this water is self-healing. This is in Mercury retrograde. It was a thunderstorm, and thunderstorms represent fast acting. So in case you ever wanted to know, snowstorms, rainstorms, windstorms, just things like that, water flowing, they all have different meanings and representations. I'll do a class on that one of these days on Rowan Temple of Light. Oh, thank you. Yeah, very, I guess I'm good at directing people through the trauma. I do try to help, and that's one thing that I've gotten some feedback on networks that I've helped them. Actually got one today that she was like, I am so glad that I came to you and talked to you. Everything you said has come true, and it came true fast, and you know, please help guide me through the next. So I feel like I've made a really good connection with somebody out there, and I'm going to be able to help them with their issues and what comes up in their life from now on. They know that they have me to count on. So I'm really excited about that. And that's why I do what I do. But anyway, speaking of trauma and tarot, I really need to get in the habit of using another deck of cards and dedicating one just for the trauma and tarot. Jeez. All right, let's go with these ones that jumped out now. Okay, so Seven of Wands. Feeling like you have to be defensive. Like, you know what? You be you, boo-boo. And don't worry about what other people think of you. Yeah, because of the shadow self. The Page of Wands. So the Page of Wands is telling you, just because people have you feeling down, don't worry about it. You are going to push through. You're going to thrive. You're going to move on to your next step. Hi, Sarah. And you're going to keep going. The last one is the Nine of Pentacles, which tells me that you are going to succeed. So just because you've been put down in the past does not mean that that is going to carry on and you're always going to be put down. You are going to find the right people that come into your life and help build you up and help you become a better version of yourself. That's what the journey is for. That's what the shadow work is for. And that is really what is going to guide you and help you in your life. So that's the trauma and tarot. Woo, baby. I'm sorry. It's when I do trauma and tarot anymore, I really feel it. You know, I really feel like it's what's meant for me to do. But yeah. So Sarah, are you just getting on here? Because I got story time. Anyway, this cold, oh my gosh, cold little bottle of water. It's been the storm water from today. I have a little bit more, but this is from today. And this little bottle is all I need to do the spell work that I need. And this is going to be for Mercury retrograde and self-transformations. And I'm going to do it not just for me, but for a collective. Because the energy, how I described it, was the big original thunderclap this morning was like Thor descended and went, "You, I have work for you to do." So, you know what? I don't think I have a Moldavite small enough to fit in that bottle. I think all my Moldavites are too big. Coincidentally, if you're looking for Moldavites, hit me up. I've got Moldavite. They're beads, but that's all that you need. You don't need a huge piece. All you need is a little one. But this will be... I can put it in a bigger jar and infuse it overnight with the Moldavite. That would be a great idea. So, anyway... Sarah and I talked today about... yes, Thor do be like that. Yes, yes, he does. I consider myself a daughter of Odin. And so the Norse pantheon, it's like Thor is like a big brother. That's kind of how we feel, you know, I feel about him. Baldur is my protector. That's just my views on it. So yes, Sarah, also, the spell jar that I made for Llamas, I did a TikTok a couple weeks ago where I just rolled it 3 times. I'm like, it's not working. So I rolled it a couple times and put some more intent into it. And then I've gotten blessed with people and abundance. You know, look at my birthday when I had 2 birthday cakes. Whenever you brought me presents, I wasn't expecting that. So I feel like I've been blessed. But what I want is financial success. So I'm thinking about taking it apart and either using a bay leaf or a piece of paper, writing on it, burning the ashes, putting the ashes in it, and re-intentionizing it. Intentionizing. I guess that's a word now. And just put redoing it. Yeah, a shaker. That's what I'll do whenever I put the... Loki is poking everybody right now. The ashes in the wax is a really good idea. Actually, I have a green candle, so I can reseal it this time with the green wax. So that would be great. Thanks for the talk. Thanks for the back and forth. I love this. I love how we can communicate. But yes, Loki has been poking at everybody lately, and I feel like he's making himself known to everybody. Yes, the spell night. That's what we're talking about tonight. Because what I intended to talk about, started to talk about, was how it went wrong. It didn't go as I had planned. And we all know how sometimes you cast a spell and it doesn't exactly go the way that you planned. But yet it still works. It just goes a roundabout way to do it. So, it is almost 7:30. I've done trauma and tarot. We've had a little bit of chat. I want to continue these. Because I'm going to be placing them over on my YouTube if I can figure out how to do it from a live. So, but you can find me on TikTok at Lady Gwen Healing there, or book me on my website. Like I said, between now and the 34th. Okay. All right, question. Waving his arms with neon signs saying, "Here I am," which I've worked with him for a while. I have his name in rings tattooed on my wrist. Loki is very much a shadow work and transformation. Like, he will help guide you and push you in a playful manner, you know, playfully, to work on yourself. So I could easily be working with him, but he and I do not have that kind of a relationship. I've seen where he goes with other people, but he doesn't with me. The one that's coming to me right now is Athena and Hecate. The Morrigan, those ones are coming to me right now, with knowledge of darkness, and then there's change. So, looking at the shadow aspects of everything. So, what's the question? But anyway, I do want to continue doing these, but as I was saying while I'm waiting on the question, if you book me over on Lady Gwendolyn Healing for any tarot reading or local power pies or custard. Okay, there. Anyway, you got me good. Anyway, what I was saying was my promotion that I have right now is if you book any time between now and October 1st, you have to use the hashtag birthday bars, and you get in the coupon code, and you get a access bars session for free. And this is for my birthday month, which was September. To expose the access bars and how good and how beneficial they are and how good they feel. So, all right, it is 7:30. I will let you all go. I will see you. If you're following me on TikTok, I go Thursday at noon live on TikTok. So you can follow me over there and have a live there. Otherwise, I will be back here every Tuesday at 7 o'clock going live for Trauma and Tarot and Talk. Have a good night.